Okay? Good day sa lahat. Sa araw na to, pag-uusapan naman natin is about oscillations and wave. When we say oscillation, so it is the process of repeating variations or of any quantity or measure about its equilibrium value in time. Okay, so pag sinabi nating oscillation, para madaling maintindihan, by simple means, guhit natin. Pag sinabi nating oscillations, we talk about parang something na nanginginig. Okay? Like this. Okay. Or like this. Or like this. Okay? So, all of these three movements means oscillations because there is a repeated variation. Okay? So, ibig sabihin ito, okay, as time pass by, this oscillation changes. Parang tumatalon. Okay? Papataas, pababa, pataas, pababa. And this variation may be approximately consistent through some times. May panahon na bumababa siya. Okay? So, one of good examples of these oscillations are, okay, na parang ganito is earthquake. Okay? Sound. Okay? So, ito yung mga good examples ng oscillations. At marami pang iba. Earthquake, sound, pwede rin yung nararamdaman mo pag nakikita mo si crash. Okay? Nanginginig ka. So, it means that there is an oscillation. Okay? If you are feeling tension, we could say that the what you are experiencing around your body, na nanginginig ka, you are shaking, so it could be oscillation. So, one good example, especially in engineering, is the earthquake, the sound, okay, etc. Okay, so, meron pa, spring. So, the displacement of spring, parang ganito, yung spring na yan eh, ganito. Okay? So, whether you push it or you pull it, it will certainly displace, magde-displace siya patungo dyan, and then babalik siya, magre-rebound siya. Parang ganyan yung movement niya. Oh. Sa sound, parang ganito din. Si earthquake, relatively magsisimula sa malakas hanggang bumaba siya with respect to time. So, ganyan yung oscillations. Anything that moves up and down and it varies through time. Yan yung oscillations. So, okay? So, when we say oscillations, we can actually model these oscillations into waves. And these waves could be in simplified form. Okay, so one of the simplest model nitong oscillations na to, okay, sa mga galaw, whether it's earth, sound, spring, or other quantity or measure, okay, na gumagalaw into a certain equation. Okay, so parang ganito. So instead na ganito yung forma, we can actually model it. For example, ito. So, we could, okay. So, one of the most beautiful equation is the cosine wave. Okay? So, previously, okay, so sa mga naka-experience na ng trigonometry, so this type of curve is actually a cosine curve.
Okay. But here,
we can actually use this type of model in order to approximate the behavior of the oscillations. Okay? So, ito yung pinakasimpleng model. A cosine of x. Okay? But instead of x and y, we can actually use time in the x-axis and the displacement or x in the y-axis. So, instead of y is equal to cosine of x, we can model it into some form. Okay? So, for this, we can model this equation into x is equal to a cosine of small omega t. Okay, so ito yung equation. Okay, so in which x is a function of time. And then your omega is the angular velocity. Okay, so just imagine this is the actual oscillation and it is moving at a constant rate of omega. And this angular velocity is usually referred into radian per unit of time. Or let us say seconds. Radian per second, radian per minute, etc. So that is what we call as angular velocity. Or the other term for this is angular frequency. So this angular frequency and angular velocity are the same thing. Okay. So ito, since my... Okay, kaya ganito yung formula niya. So it varies. It depends upon the angular velocity. And then the A here is the amplitude. Pag sinabi nating amplitude, this is the maximum vertical. Okay, ito yung maximum na naaabot nung displacement niya relative to x, okay? With respect to time. So A, so this is also A and this is also A. Upward positive value of A and this is a negative value of A. So this is the positive amplitude and this is the negative amplitude. So for constant oscillations, yung hindi humihina yung oscillations mo, meron kang positive A sa pataas at meron kang negative A pababa. Ibig sabihin yung actual na difference between the lowest ay the highest and the lowest value in oscillations is actually not A but 2A. But in order that we could perfectly model it in terms of the best mathematical way is to divide that this height into 2. And that height is 2A, so 2A divided 2 is A. So this is actually the formula for a simple oscillation. Okay, so this is just a simple oscillation equation. Okay, so marami pang pwedeng i-model dito, pero ito yung pinakamadali. Okay, but somehow, please take note that not all the time it will start at the highest point. Okay, so unlike in this model, nag-start tayo at the highest point here. Dito. Okay, so possibly siyang hindi siya mag-start at the highest point. Okay? So, pwede siya mag-start here. Okay? So, yan. So, pwede siya mag-start at a certain angle. Okay? So, let us baptize it as parang ganito yung forma niya. Yan. This value. Okay, so if there is an initial, okay, so in terms of time here, okay, so we could measure it in terms of revolution. Okay, so if this is a phase angle, okay, this is what we call as phase angle. Initial phase angle. Okay, that this is the value in which, in terms of time, before niya ma-reach yung peak niya, or let us say, the highest value along XT. So, this is A. So, it takes time bago niya maabot yung pinakamataas na position. So, we could actually integrate it into this formula. So, kapag ganito, yung equation, ay kapag ganito yung forma ng simple oscillation natin, yung formula niya is slightly magbabago. So, hindi na ito yung magiging formula. It will become like this. Okay? Kuha muna tayo ng... So, it will become like this. So, instead, kapag ganito yung forma, ito yung formula ng oscillation in terms of displacement. Okay? Pero pag mayroong phase angle into which it takes time, some amount of time in T, that it will reach the highest peak. Dito kasi, nagsimula tayo sa highest peak. So, kapag meron dito, initial phase angle, so, ang magiging formula niyan is magiging ganito. X is equal to A cosine omega T plus this, the phase angle. Okay, so ilagay ko dito para mas malaki. X is equal to A cosine omega T, okay, plus the phase, initial phase angle. So this will be your general formula for a simple harmonic oscillation. Okay, so this will be the displacement formula. Okay, so this is the formula. Okay, this is the displacement of the oscillation. Okay, at any given time. So this x is obviously a function of time. So, from this formula, we can actually derive, okay, we can actually derive the formula for the acceleration, the velocity and acceleration. So, here, we could actually integrate both sides. Differentiate rather both sides in order to get the dx over dt or the velocity at any given time. So here, okay, so we will get dx over dt or what we, or we could also rename it as velocity x is equal to dx over dt. So, given that this A is constant, and the only variable here is T, since the T is the variable, so nag-change siya with respect to T. So, kapag dinifferentiate natin ito, makukuha natin itong formula na to. Negative A, since omega is constant, so we can... Okay, pwede natin siya ipalabas. Omega A sine omega T plus the phase angle. So, this will be the formula for displacement So, ito yung magiging formula ng displacement natin. And this is your velocity. So, this is the velocity. Kapag inulit natin yung differentiation, i-differentiate natin ito, makuha naman natin si acceleration. So, yung ganito. Okay? Pag di-differentiate natin ito, lalabas ulit ito. So, magiging okay, from cosine, naging sine, negative sine siya kapag dinifferentiate. Itong sine naman, pag dinifferentiate, magiging cosine. So, magiging, meron siyang omega dito, which is the constant, katabi ng t. So, lalabas to magiging omega squared a sine. I know, magiging cosine na. Cosine omega t plus the phase angle. So, ito yung acceleration with respect to x. Yan. Ito yung magiging formula ng acceleration natin at any given time. So, we have displacement, velocity, and acceleration. So, ito yung general formula ng simple oscillations. Simple harmonic oscillations. This is for displacement, velocity, and acceleration. Okay? So, this is our introduction. So, in the next video, pag-uusapan naman natin yung mga formulas na directly pwede nating ikabit dito sa spring, okay? So, maybe i-explain ko yan in the next video.